And welcome back to KTN Morning Express. I'm Michael Karanja. Now, this morning we're going to be talking about taxes. Oh, yes, I know not what you want to talk about early this morning, but on the other hand, is someone who's actually out there looking to raise money revenues through taxes. And just to help us understand how what it takes to actually administer taxes in this country, I'm now joined by Alice Owor, who's the Commissioner for Domestic Taxes from the Kenya Revenue Authority. Alice, karibu sana.
Thank you.
Government every year keeps on setting higher targets for KRA. We look at way back from 2010, target was about 630 billion. Come to 2014, 2015, the target is 1.1 trillion shillings. Just how much pressure is the Kenya Revenue Authority under just to raise taxes, revenue through taxes?
Thank you, Karanja, for that inquiry. Let me start by first of all saying that the tax authority has got two mandates. The first one is the revenue mobilization for government, for its development agenda and other services. The second one, which is also very critical, is service delivery to Kenyans who pay taxes. It is very difficult. The pressure is very high, starting from the fact that nobody wants to pay tax willingly. And that's from the Bible days.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to pay taxes with a smile. So it becomes very difficult, and in cognizance of that challenge, KRA has tried to, through reform agenda, try to simplify and modernize its processes, so that it's much easier for taxpayers to pay taxes, as much as they might not want to do it so willingly.
Just looking at the platform, you're quite right that no one really willingly wants to pay taxes, but it's not a Kenya-centric problem. It's a problem that perhaps exists worldwide. But just looking at Kenya, how challenging has it been just to get people to actually pay taxes?
The challenge starts from the fact that not very many people are very aware of the tax law. They're not very aware of the processes.
Yeah.
And that was the first stepping stone for KRA to create awareness, do a lot of taxpayer education, sensitization, and simplification. And if I can just take you back to the days when we used to raise assessments, you'd fill manual forms, submit them to us, and we raise manual assessments, which we then post. And there was no guarantee that you'd even get that assessment. Then one day you find that you actually had a tax bill you probably were not aware of. In an effort to try and modernize the tax system, in 1992 we started a modernization program where we moved from the manual assessments to self-assessments so that your tax matters were in your hands. So under that regime, you'd still fill manual forms, your own self-assessment, and submit it to us, and pay, or sometimes you still default and we would start looking for you. So that is where the challenge now started from the tax authority, because as much as many people were filling their own self-assessments, they were still not paying, and tracing them has been a challenge.
But looking at that tax law ignorance, as it were, versus what people might say that the tax system might be a bit too complex for them to be able to know even what they owe when it comes to what is due at the end of every year or every month. When you look at that two-pronged problem, how then do you try and resolve that?
That is where the KRA modernization program has set in.
Yeah.
We started this journey when we introduced an online platform, which has now been modernized further through the development of iTax system. iTax is a web-based integrated tax management system, which not only allows the processes to be simplified and improved, it also allows the taxpayer to interact with the system and be in control of their own tax matters. For instance, we've got modules that we call client-facing modules. The first one being e-registration. You now don't need to come to KRA to get your PIN. You register online, but the first thing is you log on to our website and update your iPage. That is, if you had an old PIN, you update your iPage. That is updating your registration details, so that you even give us your email address, because all the transactions that you undertake as a taxpayer will be, KRA will interact with you through your email address.
Yeah.
So that simplicity makes it very easy for you. It's non-intrusive. You can do it from the comfort of your home. You can do it through your mobile phone. So the first front-facing module is registration module. So you are in control of your own tax matters.
Yeah.
The second one is the module that allows you to file online. So again, you can file through your mobile phone, you can file through your computer, through your iPad, laptop, wherever you are. You don't need to come to KRA. And for every transaction, you get an acknowledgement through email. If you register, the acknowledgement is a PIN certificate,
yeah,
which comes to you through your email address. If you file online, the acknowledgement is an acknowledgement slip again through your email address, which confirms that we've received your return. The third front-facing module, which again we've introduced to help help taxpayers manage their tax affairs, is you can now e-pay. And towards this, we've partnered with about 35 commercial banks. Mm-hmm. All the key banks are in there. And you can now pay your taxes through those banks. And again, you'll produce an e-slip as you make your return online. You get an e-slip through which you can now instruct your bank to pay on your behalf. And instantly, the minute the payment is made, your ledger is updated. And again, you now have control of your tax matters because you can see your ledger.
Yeah.
You can go in there, query your ledger, you'll see all the credits, all the payments you've made, you'll have all the debits, that is the assessments that you've raised by filling in your return. So again, you're in control of all this. So that simplification alone has made it much easier for taxpayers to now pay and for tax administration to manage revenue collection.
What's the compliance like right now?
The compliance rate is still not where we want it, yeah, but it is improving because, for instance, now we have about 40% of registered VAT payers actually filing online and paying through their banks. We've even made it simpler. You can actually pay your taxes through the mobile phone, through M-Pesa, through Airtel Money. for small amounts, like up to about 70,000 shillings, you can make all those payments. So, because one of the first things that we realized before we modernized was that compliance rate was much lower because taxpayers found it difficult.
So I can remember the long queues outside KRA, so no one would want to come and up there and queue for about 2 days just to get attended to.
Exactly. So we want to get rid of the queues. They are not quite gone yet. If you come on 20th, you'll still find queues. I don't know whether it's a Kenyan thing, but we like coming last minute, and we like making our lives so difficult. We've tried to make it so simple. We are telling you, you don't have to come to Times Tower. From the comfort of your home, you can e-file, you can e-pay, you can make inquiries. We've even made it better. You can now, for purposes of services, you remember I said KRA also offers services.
Yep.
One of the service areas is issuance of tax compliance certificates. Everybody needs it. You want a public job, you want to participate in a public tender, you need a tax compliance certificate. You don't have to come to KRA anymore. No forms to fill. You go to the website, onto our portal, you fill in your application, a very simple form, which goes straight to an officer who then quickly checks your tax compliance compliance status. If you don't have any issues, you'll get an approval will be made by the officer through a back office module, and the tax compliance certificate will hit your inbox through your email. It is so simple.
Yeah.
Those who are claiming refunds, you know the noise that we used to hear about delays in refund processing. You don't hear that noise much or anymore. because we've again simplified. So we are telling taxpayers the module is there in iTax. Just submit your refund claim through iTax. The processing is much, much faster. It's not as tedious as it used to be before.
So when you hear the clamor that is out there, because there's still a bit of noise when it comes to VAT refund, is it largely for the large taxpayer group, or is it that's something that cuts across even to domestic and even smallholder taxpayers? Because a number of companies still claiming refunds even to the tune of about 5 billion shillings.
Okay, let me say that this is more of a historical problem.
Yeah.
These are areas of, you know, when the system was still not as efficient, which is something that we are working on. In fact, by end of June, I think you'll not be hearing much. We intend to process almost all those refund claims that we received, of course subject to getting some money from Treasury to pay them off, because the processing can be done, but if we don't have enough funds to pay them off, then that would be a separate issue. But internally, these are just the historical legacy challenges that we had because of the manual process. And that's why we are moving away from that manual process, because it was very tedious. What we are doing now, we are giving taxpayers a chance to file online, file their VAT. First of all, you file the VAT return,
yeah,
and then you fill in your submission for refund claim also online. It is processed online, and it hits your account online.
Because the backlog, I can imagine, was much longer. So I can imagine the journey is trying to clean the slate and start afresh when you're able to deal with VAT refunds more or less on an annual basis.
Yes.
But given that there are still people with VAT refunds and they have been talking about restructuring them so that either they get a tax break equivalent to what is owed to them in terms of VAT refunds. Now, in that kind of discussion, is that something that as a KRA that you've discussed, or something that perhaps going forward you might consider?
It's something that is actually under discussion.
Yep.
Not just discussion, it's under action. We are working with Treasury on that. All the past claims that were there before are under a special regime. We've actually put a task force to make sure that all those claims are processed by end of June. So we just have got 2 months. Thereafter, then we'll be determining how much is payable, which we've processed, and Treasury will sort us out in terms of how that is then funded. But for the current claims, I can assure you there are no complaints, because we process them within less than 2 months and have them paid, yep, so long as the funding is available. But I think for me, the key emphasis here is we've automated all these processes now. You don't have to, I mean, taxpayers don't have to bring in manual forms,
yeah,
for refunds. The first step is for them to e-file. And of course, before you e-file, you must e-register or update your registration details through the iTax Plus platform. And this makes it much easier.
Let's come back down to the unit that you handle, the domestic taxes. And there's been some talking to some people, some people who deal with taxes, and they have been of the opinion that KRA has no business chasing after the small taxpayer group, in the very essence that there are too many and they are bits scattered all over town, so it becomes much harder for you to administer. Conversation has been that you could employ or even use county governments that are more in touch with those with businesses at the more local level to help you administer that taxes at that level. Is that something perhaps the KRA has considered?
Yes, Karanja. Actually, we have considered that.
Yeah.
The first realization that we had, of course, is that money went to the counties.
Yeah.
Money was devolved to the counties. That is where a lot of business is taking place. And because of that, because of the county's presence, taxpayers have also gone back to the counties, because they know now they can do business at county level.
Yeah.
So counties have got strength in terms of grassroots presence. KRA has got strength in terms of systems and experience in tax administration. So what we are looking at is partnering with counties so that we can even twin the issuance of single business permits with payment of the simple tax, which we call turnover tax.
Yeah.
We try to simplify it so that it is just based on turnover. 3% of your turnover, we don't ask questions, you don't have to keep records. You only need to know your turnover because the tax is based on it. But there's still room for improvement. We can actually make it even much simpler. Maybe you pay once a year when you are renewing your single business license.
Yeah.
Those are discussions we want to hold with the county governments, so that if it is easier to pay it to the county government on behalf of KRA, we'll be holding those discussions.
Obviously.
So that we've made it simple so that you even for turnover taxpayers, the small ones, they can still pay through their mobile.
Yeah.
We make it simple. So we'll be looking at which is the most convenient for them. But we know that, yes, through the county government, partnering with them, we can make a lot of mileage.
Obviously, one of the mandates you have is lessening the tax burden for individuals. But when it comes to enforcement, perhaps, how stringent or how tough have you been on it? Because I guess if one or two, three people went, were held and actually went behind bars for lack of paying taxes or even tax evasion, as it were, perhaps it would spur people into becoming more tax compliant.
You're very right. Our starting point, because we are going through a lot of change management at the moment, we want to first of all facilitate our clients so that they can then trust us to be able to pay more readily and pay with a smile. So the trust and facilitation is our clarion call right now.
Yeah.
Where first of all we realize that yes, a lot of taxpayers might not be aware. So we are doing a lot of taxpayer education, sensitization, giving a lot of support. I'm sure you've seen we've opened a lot of support centers, iTax support centers. And this is for purposes of giving support, starting from the softer end of giving support, facilitation, education, so that now you know what is right.
Yeah.
At that point, if you still don't want to comply, then certainly our enforcement measures are also going to be much stronger. We actually want to have a specific unit that will just be dealing with enforcement.
Yeah.
But for now, we want to focus more on facilitation because we believe somebody who is facilitated would be a much better taxpayer than a person whom you just enforce without having, yes, cracked down, without having shown them how to do it.
Yeah.
That's why you've seen even the publicity that we're having on iTax. We want to show you how to do it first, and then thereafter, if you still don't want to comply, then we'll have no choice but to do enforcement. So we are spreading our wings in terms of support areas, support centers.
Yeah.
You can find us in any of the Huduma centers that have been opened. We have a corner, a tax corner, that offers support also to taxpayers. We've opened support centers. We have one in Nairobi at the Railway Club within the Uhuru Park.
Yeah.
We have one in Kisumu, Swan Center. We have one in Mombasa. Nyeri is operational. Thika has also started operating. We are soon opening one in Nakuru. And Eldoret is also operational. And very soon we'll be opening much more. Garissa, Embu, Meru, name it, we'll be there. Just to make it easy for our taxpayers to be able to comply more easily. And of course, we want them to use the online platform because that way they can control their tax matters. You can actually see your debt.
Yeah.
You can get onto the platform, check your ledger, and if you owe anything, then you can quickly pay because penalties are stringent.
All right.
They're very stringent.
At least we're in May. June is financial year is coming to a close. Are we close to the 1.1 trillion shilling target?
We are getting there. We are fairly close. June is a major due date. May is not so big, but June is a fairly large due date.
Yeah.
We, of course, are working towards meeting our target, using all manner of ways. Persuasion, enforcement.
Enforcement.
But There's one aspect that we've introduced which we are hoping again we'll be able to leverage on to make it easier for taxpayers again to comply. We found that a lot of our taxes were held up in disputed cases, people rushing to court. But we are giving them a middle ground. We have created a division that deals with the alternative dispute resolution. As you are aware, that was provided for even in the current constitution,
yeah.
Where you can actually have a middle ground between a tax dispute resolution tribunal, and the courts. So the middle ground is where you can come to the table and we discuss your tax matters and amicably have them resolved. We reach a middle ground, and then you can pay your taxes.
Making it much easier for the taxpayer.
Making it much easier.
All right.
Yeah, through a conversation.
Thank you very much, Alice. That has been Alice Orour, the Commissioner for Domestic Taxes, is telling us more about how KRA is working towards and making sure that making care tax payments becomes much simpler for an individual, helping them also raise their huge targets that they actually set by the national.